Love and Light Collective, welcome back to Kiera's Love Tarot. I truly appreciate each and every one of you guys who clicked on my video to hear what it is that I have to say. Thank you so much, okay? And even if you don't stay the full way through, I appreciate your click through. Also, please keep in mind this is a general reading. There's no name on this reading. Even though my readings may fit like a personal, only take what resonates with you and do something positive with it, okay? I don't want nobody walking away from this reading feeling depressed, stressed, worried, okay? Only take what's yours. Love and light to you guys. For my new subscribers, well, not new subscribers, for the new people here that have just found me, please subscribe to my channel and become a family member of mine, okay? Everybody is welcome. And I just like new people on my channel. I like interacting with my subscribers. I like talking to y'all. I talks back, so don't be afraid to subscribe and join into the team. All my day one subscribers, y'all already know how we gets down over here. We embrace each other. We show love to each other. We talk to each other. So for those of you guys who are new, welcome to the team. Welcome to the Soul Tribe. Get comfortable and relax and enjoy this reading, okay? It may not resonate with everybody because I pick up on energies for those who need to hear the message that I put out. So if this video don't resonate, you're more than welcome to go down my page and find something that resonates or wait for the next post, okay? But love and light to you guys. Let's enjoy this reading. Let's tap in. Make sure y'all hitting that like button, okay? All throughout the video, for those of you who be forgetting to give likes and energetic love back to the tarot readers who post every day, okay? Y'all need to be liking everybody's video. Every person who takes time out to post videos and give you guys messages, make sure y'all showing us love by liking our videos, helping our videos get pushed out there to the collective, okay? Show us love, okay? So let's go ahead and tap in, Spirit. What messages do you have for my collective viewers? What messages do you have for my collective viewers? What's going on today on this Wednesday, okay? It's a little gloomy outside where I am. It's raining, so I don't know. Let's see what Spirit has to say. Let's see what Spirit has to say on this rainy day for some. Not everybody is experiencing a rainy day, but let's see what Spirit has to say. What is going on? Okay, we got Scholar. Okay, so somebody might have recently came across opportunity to go to school, okay? Or somebody could be thinking about going back to school, okay? Or somebody is in school and they're getting back into their books. Somebody realizes that they've been neglecting school, or they've been distracted too much from school, or somebody was failing some college courses due to things and situations that were presented to them in their life. So somebody's finally like had a light bulb go off in their mind, like, hey, I need to get back into my books. Or somebody realizes that they had a scholarship that was presented to them and they didn't take advantage of it. Somebody wishes they would have took advantage of a scholarship. Also, somebody could be a scholar, like a really smart individual that chose to go a different route in life. Somebody had it all set up for themselves and they chose to go somewhere else. So now somebody's regretting that. But I do feel like a lot of the collective has been doing a lot of reading. Somebody could be reading Think Like a Man, the book by Steve Harvey, or someone could be just reading books about relationships. Somebody could be reading books about crystals and spirituality. Somebody could be doing reading on how to cope with pain or depression. But there's just a lot of reading going on I'm picking up, okay? Somebody could also be thinking about setting up a library. Well, not a literal library, but a book area in their home. Or just somebody's buying a lot of books from Barnes and Nobles or off Amazon. Somebody's trying to get their education up. Somebody's trying to re-educate themselves. Or somebody's just doing a lot of reading to distract themselves from things that are they're experiencing around them. Okay, somebody could have gray hair or naturally have gray hair, like literally was born with gray hair, or have gray streaks. Okay, this could be a man doing a lot of reading. A fit man, somebody who is in a gym a lot, or either just, you know, very fit. This could also be a woman, okay? It could be a woman or a man that are experiencing these things. But I do heavily pick up that somebody was a scholar, okay? And their life took a wild turn. And somebody's just looking at how life could have been if they would have, you know, pursued school. Or somebody's thinking about pursuing school. What other messages do we have, Spirit? What else is going on today? We got two messages. We got enemy, an old woman, okay? There could be somebody, okay, so with the scholarship card coming out as well, or the scholar card coming out, I feel like maybe somebody convinced somebody that school wasn't for them. Like, and this could have been because, and I got a burp coming out, like, here we go with this burping, this spiritual burping, so that's confirmation, okay? Somebody was in school, or somebody had an opportunity to better themselves, or somebody was naturally smart, had a, like, or somebody could have lived like a new lifestyle, like from what's that movie called? How could I forget? I was gonna say Love and Hip Hop ATL. How could I forget that movie's name, y'all? Please don't judge me. That was one of my favorite movies with Nunu and T.I. Whatever the movie's called. I can't think about it right now because I'm tapped in. But for those of you who know what movie I'm talking about, how she was low-key rich as hell, but she kept going to the hood. She wanted to live a hood lifestyle. She wanted to experience the trenches and having a trenches type lifestyle when she had everything handed to her and set up for her. She had a comfortable environment, but she would rather be uncomfortable just because that's, you know, you get people that are rich and come from a good background that got, and they may not even be rich, they just come from a good background. They're well taken care of. They have opportunities, but yet they still want to go in a negative direction. So somebody had everything given to them, handed to them, and they could have had an enemy energy, okay, or somebody that was appearing to be a friend or appearing like they care about their well-being, but secretly had this downfall energy towards you, or toward this energy I'm talking about. But an enemy could have convinced somebody with a very good lifestyle, or with a good education background, or somebody that's really smart, to take time off, wait to go back to school, or you don't need to finish school right now, or school ain't gonna pay the bills at the moment. Like, somebody got convinced that going to college or going back to school wasn't a good idea for them. Now somebody feels bad for letting a person that turned out to be an enemy, or all along was hating on them, give them that advice. Okay, then we got an old woman. There could have been an older woman and some sort of person that turned out to be an enemy all along, convincing someone school wasn't for them. But there also could have been an older woman trying to tell somebody to make a right decision, get your stuff together, do what's right, and you can have fun later. And this enemy energy, this could have been a friend. Like, no, school gonna take up your whole life. You're gonna spend the rest of your life paying back student loans, and it's pointless to go to college. So, but somebody's heavily wishing they went to college, okay? Or somebody's just back in school now because they don't have nobody telling them that they shouldn't be in school, or they don't have any distractions around, okay? So that's a message for somebody that's in college or thinking about going back to school. We got the Seven of Wands. Be decisive. Confusion will be your greatest enemy. And it's crazy how this card is coming out, okay? We got the Seven of Wands coming out in reverse. Somebody was indecisive about a scholarship or just an opportunity to better themselves. And it only have to resonate with school. It could just be, like I said, you're a smart individual. You have knowledge. You're good at, somebody's really good at math. Somebody's really good at reading. Somebody's really good at philosophy. I was going to say philosophy. Somebody's really good at psychology, or somebody's going to school to be a psychologist, or, and for, I'm hearing for somebody, somebody needed to go through a really hard relationship, or go through experience a bad breakup, so that it would trigger them to want to go to school for psychology, because you going to school for psychology is going to help people. Okay. Somebody is a starseed that's watching this video, or a light worker, or has a plan to help others. And psychological help is what a lot of people need, honestly, okay? So with the Seven of Wands coming out, this is spirits telling you guys, stop being decisive if you're thinking about going to school, or you're thinking about doing something to better yourself, because confusion will be your greatest enemy, okay? Somebody allows people around them to confuse them. And that's so crazy how this enemy card is out, okay? Somebody could have a lot of people that don't want to see people doing good surrounded around them. And I'll be glad when a lot of my collective wakes up and smells the coffee and removes these energies out of their life, so they'll stop showing up in these readings, okay? Because somebody keeps on trying to bring in people with them on their boat of success when they didn't do the work. You did the work, but they didn't do the work, and they're trying to come with you, or you're trying to bring them with you because somebody's afraid of being alone. But why are you afraid of being alone when you smart as hell, okay? You got this scholar energy about you. You know how to figure shit out. Somebody know how to figure shit out, okay? You give into demands of others. So somebody let somebody convince them to not go to school or not do something that was going to make them financially stable. And now somebody's regretting it. Somebody wish they wouldn't have let others make decisions for them that are not in their best interest, okay? Somebody let somebody make a decision for them, or somebody's battling breaking away from people that make decisions for them, or somebody has a weak mindset when it comes down to making decisions for themselves, or they care too much about letting others down. Somebody needs to live their life and not let others live life for them. Because what somebody needs to understand, a motherfucker gonna do what makes them happy. They'll tell you all day what you shouldn't do, but they gonna do what they need to do. They're going to do what makes them happy. They're going to be with who make them happy. They can tell you all day, oh, leave that motherfucker. They doing you this. Or they ain't on shit. They ain't got shit going for them. Or this person do you like this. I'm not condoning toxic relationships, because if this person is telling you to leave a fucked up individual, I don't blame them. But you get people that just feel like, couldn't be me. Because, yeah, it ain't you. Because you don't have somebody that is in a relationship with you, or you don't have anybody that is interested. Not putting down somebody that don't have anybody, but it be the people that ain't never been through shit or been through what you're going through that's speaking on your situation, okay? So somebody needs to stop letting people speak on their situations, especially if you know this person can't even relate. Now, I'm not telling you guys don't listen to advice, because you get people that really know what they're talking about, and you get people that really do mean you well. But y'all know, y'all got intuition. Everybody has common sense. God don't let nobody down. Okay. God don't send nobody into nothing without the tools to get through it. So everybody has intuition. It's just not everybody knows how to use it or chooses to use it and listen to it. So when you gotta, if you in a relationship and you know, you got bad going on in a relationship, but you got a lot of good going on too. But you only talk about your relationship when it's the bad going on. First of all, that's what someone needs to stop doing. If you know that your relationship ain't always bad, but you only telling people about the bad parts of your relationship, they're going to look at your person like, I don't fuck with this person. They doing my sister or cousin or brother or uncle wrong, or niece, whoever you are, granddaughter, okay? If you know your relationship is good at times, it ain't all bad, y'all need to also brag about the good parts if you want people to not look at y'all person in a bad light. But once again, y'all, some of you guys watching this video, you got some very toxic energies that try to be in y'all life, okay? So I don't blame some of these people for telling y'all to step away from these connections. But like I said, we got serpents and Jezebels and all these fucked up ass energies that are low-key your enemy, low-key envious, low-key want what you got, low-key don't want to see you in a better position, low-key want to kick you when you down, like all of that shit, all things that comes with somebody being an enemy, okay? But some of you guys are choosing to keep your enemies close too. You think that's the best way to keep a person from betraying you, but that's not true. It's actually keeping a blockage in your life. No, we're not keeping enemies close. We're keeping enemies the fuck from around us. That's what we're doing, okay? And that's what somebody needs to do, keep an enemy the fuck from around them. But yeah, back to my example, like, it's a difference from when your person just consistently got you fucked up, but it's a difference when you just, okay, a person know damn well you ain't always complaining about your relationship. You just going through it and they're thirsty to tell you to leave. When they know damn well this man or this woman make sure you straight, they make sure you good. Everybody may not resonate with this example, but you know, they got their ways. And sometimes people's ways could be fixed or are fixable. And I feel like somebody just be like, nah, I don't want them in that commitment, or I don't want them with a person, or because I don't have a person. So they'll tell you things like, oh, leave them alone, a man like this or a man like that. That be hater energy for somebody, okay? Somebody got a hater that can't wait for you to be in drama so they can tell you how to be fucked up even worse, okay? That's a message for somebody. You have to live of regrets of this action for a long time if you continue to allow people to make decisions with the Seven of Wands coming out in reverse, okay? So if somebody wants to go to school, or if somebody's trying to go to school, and also I feel like somebody could be trying to go back to school, but they could have an older woman making it hard for them, like not wanting to watch kids for them. Somebody may have an older woman as a babysitter, and this babysitter could low-key be an enemy. I don't know who this is in your life, but it's an older energy, okay? And they make excuses or just make reasons as to why they ain't available to help you out, why you go to school to do something better for yourself. Because low-key, somebody's unhappy with the decisions they made with their life, and somebody's older and bitter about things. So they don't want the people around them, you know, successful, which is so stupid, okay? But if somebody don't get out there and embrace the brain that they have, they're going to regret it for a very long time, okay? Somebody has several options that they can go, or several directions that they can go in at the moment. So you guys need to definitely embrace that energy, okay? Figure out what snakes are in your corner and get them out so you could be successful. And love and light, guys, that is you guys' message for this video. I will be back with another one, okay? Hope that resonated.